Good morning, children. Children, in my last video, I have explained you what is a sentence and different kinds of sentences. So we have learned that a sentence is a group of words that has complete meaning or that gives some sense, right? And it has four different kinds of sentences, four different kinds. Like first one was an assertive sentence or declarative sentence. Second was imperative sentence, then interrogative sentence and exclamatory sentence. I have explained you everything in detail. I have given you so many examples and we have done all the book exercises also. Today we are going to learn about sentence, but to how to divide a sentence into two parts we are going to learn. Okay children, see, as you can see on the screen, on the wooden board, it's written subject and predicate. Yes, we are going to learn subject and predicate. Children, you know, a sentence is divided into two parts. First part tells us about the person or anything, noun, which we are talking about, whom we are talking about. And the rest of the part tells us that what we are talking about, the first part, right? So it is divided into two parts. So let us first read these sentences. Okay, chapter 29, subject and predicate. The cow moos. Come here at once. Where is Suparna? What a spectacular shot. So children, again we can see here different kinds of sentences. Just we have read in a previous video, the cow moos. It is giving information. So it is declarative or assertive sentence. And yes, we know a sentence starts with a capital letter and ends with either a full stop, capital letter, a full stop, question mark or an exclamation mark. So first one is assertive or declarative sentence. Next one is come here at once. It is an order, command. So it is an imperative sentence. It also ends with full stop. Third one is, we can see question, it is a question. Okay, a question mark is also there. So it is an interrogative sentence. And last one is, we can see an exclamation mark here. So it is expressing the emotions, feelings, okay? So it is an exclamatory sentence. So children, we have seen here four different kinds of sentences. But why are few words underlined here? Like the cow moos. Children, can you tell me whom we are talking about here? We are talking about the cow. Fine. So the cow is the subject here. We are talking about the cow. So children, you know whom we talk about? It becomes subject. And what we are talking about the subject will become predicate. So the cow, it is a subject because we are talking about the cow, and moos. What we are talking about the cow, that it moves. So it is predicate. In the same way, come here at once. Children, you know what happened? When we say come here, go there, sit down, stand up, open the window. So one word is hidden there, you. We don't say you come here, you go there, you sit down, you stand up, you complete your work, you open the window, you shut down the computer, like this. We don't use you all the time because it is understood that I am talking to you. So we say come here, go there, sit down, stand up, like this. So here subject is hidden. Subject is you, it is hidden. And the rest of the sentence is predicate. Where is Suparna? Who we are talking about here? Suparna. So Suparna will become subject and rest of the sentence will become predicate. What a spectacular shot. So what we are talking about here? Shot. So shot will become subject and what we are talking about here? What a spectacular. So it will become predicate. So we will learn this in detail in the next slide. The words in bold are subjects. The underlined words are predicates. So what a subject? What is a subject? The subject tells us whom or what the sentence is about. Or simply you can say whom we are talking about. The subject can be one word, a group of words or a pronoun also. Suppose I will say he is a good boy. So we are talking about he here. So it is a pronoun. And you know children, more than one word also can be a subject. Suppose I am saying Ram, Shyam and Mohan are best friends. So I am talking about three boys here. So Mohan, Ram, Rohan and Shyam, they will become subject. Okay. Suppose I am saying the water in that bottle is dirty. So whom I am talking about here? The water in that bottle. You will not say only water. It is wrong. The water in that bottle. will become subject. Suppose I am saying the students of class 6 are notorious. So whom I am talking about here? The students? No, the students of class 6. Fine. So please take care whom we are talking about. You have to take care of that. The predicate tells us what the subject is or does. So already I have told you the predicate tells about the subject. The predicate can be one word or a group of words like we have learned just now. Now children, you know, in different kinds of sentences, subjects and predicate differs. Let us see how. In a declarative sentence, the subject can be at the beginning of the sentence, in the middle or the end. Yes, it is very important point, children. Many students think or they are confused. They think like a subject can be present only in the beginning. No, it can be present in the beginning, in the middle and the end, and sometimes hidden also. So let's see the examples here. Like Batul and Zohair drink milk in the morning. So subject is present in the beginning. In the morning, Batul and Zohair drink milk. So subject is present in the middle of the sentence. In the morning, milk is drunk by Batul and Zohair. So it is present at the end of the sentence. So subject can be present anywhere. In an imperative sentence, the subject is you, as I have told you now. The you is usually implied in these sentences, like please close the door, stand in a line. So we don't use you, please close the door, you stand a line. Fine. So you is always hidden, it is understood. In interrogative and exclamatory sentences, the word order is changed. The subject can be in the middle or the end of the sentence. See how. Children, when we frame an interrogative sentence, we start with a question word or the helping verb. Like here it's given, is Asha absent today? So is this helping verb? Okay, I can also write, where is Asha? So we are talking about Asha. So in interrogative sentence, what happened? It can be in the middle or at the end. Fine. An exclamatory sentence also, children, like when I say, what a nice thing he did. Okay, so he is subject, we are talking about he. Now just we have read how, let's suppose we are saying how exciting the match was, so we are talking about the match. So the match is subject. And just now we have read about the shot, what a spectacular shot. So we are talking about shot, so it is present at the end. So children, just keep in your mind that subject can be anywhere. Now let us do the book exercise. You have to circle the subjects and underline the predicates in these sentences. One is already done for you. Number one, the eagle sat on the highest branch of the tree. So here we are talking about the eagle, so it is subject. So we have circled it, and rest of the sentence will become predicate, so you will underline it. Question number two is, Rakhi ran down the stairs and out of the door. Who we are talking about here, children? We are talking about Rakhi, and rest of the sentence will become predicate. The paint on the walls is peeling. So whom we are talking about here? The paint. Which paint? The paint on the walls. So please take care of this, children. The paint on the walls is subject. Annie, Tom and Mona went to the seaside on Friday. So whom we are talking about here? Annie, Tom and Mona. The happy children waved to the soldiers marching by. So whom we are talking about here? The happy children. The captain stayed with his crew till the end. Whom we are talking about here? The captain. Oil paintings on canvas were part of the exhibition. So whom we are talking about here? Oil paintings. Which oil paintings? The oil paintings on canvas. The weather on the mountain continued to be warm and sunny. So are we talking about the weather or the weather on the mountain? So please take care. The weather on the mountain. So children, the weather near the river, the weather in your house, so it differs. So please take care of this, the weather on the mountain. Now complete these sentences with suitable subjects. Oh, very simple, children. The predicate is already given. You only have to fill the subject. And one more thing, I am writing my means own answer. You can write your own answer. Don't copy it down, please. You can just take the idea, but don't copy it down. Who entered Devika's room? A pretty girl. You can write any other girl, any other friend, or you entered, I entered Devika's room, anything. Das has been bought by Sudhir, this beautiful gift. Across the river swam the best swimmers. You can write your name also, anything you can write. But it should be correct, okay? You cannot write anything. The answer should be correct. the students of class 6 will be going for the picnic next week. Or you can write, my parents will go, I will be going, my teachers will be going, anything. The teacher told them about the fierce dinosaurs of the past. On the walls of the museum hung the most famous painting. You can write some other thing. The hard-working artist worked on the canvas. Okay, question number 6, children. Subject is already given. You have to fill the suitable predicates. Like, first one is done for you. Diya and her sister went to buy a present for their mother. You can write any other thing also. Like, first one is already done. You have to do the rest of the questions. Like, I have written 200 people attended the party in my new home. You write any other thing. 200 people went to watch the show. He was the first person to congratulate me. For my new house, I can also add it here. None of the children wasted food in the party. This street is famous for the beautiful gift shops. All teams played well in the tournament. The tiny little mouse was killed by the cat, chased by the cat. Anything? The tiny little mouse hid itself in the hole. The boy in the yellow shirt is my younger brother or my friend. Anything? So children, it was very simple. Again, I want to do revision just for 2 minutes. What is subject and predicate? Fine, a sentence is divided into two parts, a subject and a predicate. So subject tells us about whom we are talking, and predicate tells us about the subject. That's all. Okay, I hope you have understood. You can do the book exercise on your own. That's all for today, children. Thank you.